jokes, and I'm getting paid for this. Now, this is not work. This is way too much fun to be considered work. And I do have a lot of fun down here. And I promise you, my jokes get worse as the tour goes on. Now, we've left the natural float. This is actually called man-made. This has got a concrete bottom where we're at. Now, everything in front of you was cut out in the 60s. In 1968, we had two major events that really put San Antonio on the map. We had the World's Fair come to our city, and we were 250 years old. The combination of both events, we had 70 million visitors come to San Antonio. Our city planners knew traffic was going to be a nightmare, so this got cut out for more boats, and they widened sidewalks at the same time. Now, our Chamber of Commerce is the building on the left. That happened. If any of you are thinking of moving here, I strongly recommend that you dial 1-210 Chamber, C-H-A-M-B-E-R. My wife and I moved here over 3.5 years ago. We got a packet from them that told us of various condos, apartment complexes. We also got some wonderful discount coupons. Made our moves so much easier. Now, everywhere I'm taking you today, this is part of our parade route. Yes, we do have parades down here. There are street parades downtown as well, but I don't talk about them because they aren't as much fun as the ones down here on the water. And this is also part of our city park system. Yes, it really is. That's why I have a beautiful office. The city does a great job day or nighttime of keeping this place beautiful all year round. Now, on the right side of the boat, this waterfall is one of the most popular places for photos. At least once a week, we have somebody down here in bridal attire. And I did meet a gentleman not too long ago. He is third generation to have his high school senior picture taken there. Now, I did mention our ducks earlier. Most of the ducks you'll see down here, they're either teals or mallards. But we do have a few black and white ones. Those guys are called Muskogee ducks. And we do have fish on our river. Yes, we really do. We have long-eared sunfish, we have bass, and a whole mess of catfish. Especially up by our restaurants. Whatever our well-fed ducks don't eat, and as you can see, our ducks are pretty well-fed, well, it falls to the bottom. The catfish being bottom feeders do a great job of cleanup, ladies and gentlemen. One boat coming into CCX. I'll wait. Now, as we come in here, you can see it is just get a little bit crowded, and I don't drive too fast because we really don't want to play bumper boats with folks. Now, if you look up high in the sky, in the right front corner of the boat, one boat coming into CCX. If you look up high in the sky in the right front corner of the boat, you're going to see what looks to be a big spaceship. That was the highlight of the 68 World's Fair. That is the second tallest freestanding tower in the country. The tallest one's in Vegas, and we don't care about that one. It's actually the Towers of America. There's a restaurant at the top that rotates, so you can get a panoramic view of our city. And an observation tower up there as well. Now we are coming into the Henry Gonzalez Convention Center. It can be a little bit of a wind tunnel this time of year, so please batten down the hatches. Yes, I have had to go fishing for hats before, but it's not my favorite thing to fish for. I'm sorry? Go up in the towers and what? Yes, there is. Our convention center was named after Henry Gonzalez. Henry was the very first Hispanic American elected to the House of Representatives. That actually happened in 1961, and he served 30 good years for us. Now, the biggest mural in all of Texas is over here on the top left. And I do turn the boat around so everybody can see it. That mural is 130 feet by 22 feet. There's over 400,000 tile in that mural. It was a gift, also from Mexico in 68 for the World's Fair. It's called the Confluence of Civilization, the merging of East and West cultures coming together right over the Alamo. Now, the artist who did that artwork, his name is Juan O'Gorman, Hispanic mom, Irish dad. No, I'm not kidding. And the artwork itself, it's on top of the Lila Cockrell Theater. Miss Cockrell was our very first female mayor we ever had, and she served three terrific terms for us. And I will turn the boat around. We do that by driving around this little island in front of us. They just reopened up this section of the river about 9 weeks ago. It was closed for a long time. Now, if you remember, I said this is part of our parade route. Well, after our
holiday, step it into.
When that track was originally installed, somebody put the wrong bolts in there. They stuck out so far that it would actually punch holes in the sides of the boat. Riverboat captains, we didn't drive around this for a long time, but after the parade, they realized we weren't kidding. Well, the city did come through and change out all the bolts. They did a wonderful job. Unfortunately, they also changed the angle of this track. They set it up perfectly for a boat 22 feet long. Guess what? All our tour boats are 26 feet long. There's no nice way to say it. We're going to play bumper boat as we come up here. Now, I should point out, 3 weeks ago on Thursday, we had four boatloads of second graders come down here. Their tour is much different than yours. We play bumper boats. You see, second graders bounce real well. Grown-ups, we don't bounce as well as we used to. So we try not to play bumper boats too much. But when I came up here, I didn't even try and hit this thing. I will tell you now, I actually knocked four of them out of their chairs. The record is 12. And yes, we do keep track of those kind of things when we have grade school kids here. Like I said, we do bounce just a little bit, but not too bad this time. For those of you that are wondering, on the back of all of our tour boats, it is a 9.9 horsepower motor. My wife has a bigger sewing machine motor than this thing's got. And all of our boats do run off of compressed natural gas, which is great for the ecology and the economy down here. There we go. And now the mural will be on the right side of the boat. And again, it is quite intricate and very beautiful, ladies and gentlemen. Now in front of the boat is the Marriott Hotel. When the Marriott wanted to build right there, they ran into a slight problem. There was a three-story building in that same location called the Fairmont Hotel. Now some say the Fairmont Hotel was a historical, some say hysterical building because it was not in very good shape, and Marriott was told point blank they could not tear it down. So they moved it, literally. They jacked up the whole building as one great big chunk. That building weighed 116,000 tons. They put 132 axles underneath it. Underneath every axle was a pneumatic or air-filled tire. They took it straight down Alamo Street. It took them 6 days to move that building 6 blocks.
That's good, Rusty.
The wind is blowing around the boat.
All right, you're aerodynamic.
I'm sorry, say again?
Starting now, Sarah's going to be closed.
Okay, thank you. Now, if you look on the left-hand side of the boat and in front of the boat, you're going to notice there are bumps on the ground. Well, the bumps are part of the root system of the trees here. These trees are called bald cypress trees. Now, they are the only cypress tree that loses their leaves in the wintertime. And according to the National Arbor Day Society, the only tree that grows their roots quite like that, ladies and gentlemen. And you will find quite a few of our bald cypress trees down here along the river. There are actually 7 different types of cypress trees along the river. Now, right in front of the boat, on that far bank, there is a big bronze statue. That came from Portugal. It happens to be their patron saint, San Antonio, since that is the name of our beautiful river and our wonderful city. They do feel a little bit of a kinship with us here. Entering RCX. Now, as we come in here, I don't drive again real fast because it does get crowded. If you notice, there's a whole bunch of people standing up by that rail. Well, in case you're wondering, all those folks, they're all called tourists. Now, you guys are celebrities. You're on my boat. Do not get confused, ladies and gentlemen. as we come up here, we are coming into River Center. This is our downtown shopping mall. And there's over 100 stores up here. And trust me when I tell you that my wife and both of my daughters have been in every one of these stores that we've walked. When I come shopping up here with them, I'm always packing their and usually ask about your dad. They're now grandparents. So wrap on to what's been saving to open up. And I love that part. That's a whole other story if you want to go there. Also up here, you will find an IMAX theater, regular theaters, comedy club, as well as some excellent restaurants. So it is a lot of fun down here. This is just a nice place to come, sit, relax, and enjoy the music. Drive around in service is a very popular place to purchase as well. Now there's a band over here on the left side. They are from South America and they're here every day. I'm going to let you do a little bit of listening while I'm driving. Of course they quit playing when I come up here. Last time I came in here they started playing the theme from Gilligan's Island. They actually have quite a sense of humor. And trust me, my wife has all their CDs. I swear she does. Now this island, from Thanksgiving to Christmas, every Saturday, Santa was on top of that island. He always had a gazillion smiling little faces around him. It's actually a lot of fun to be down here for that. Like I said, it's a nice place to sit, relax, and enjoy yourself down here. I'm sorry? How cold does it get in our wintertime? Well, usually in the mid-30s. We actually had a bizarre incident happen this winter. We had 2 days in a row where it dropped to 20 degrees. Our entire city shut down. I kid you not. Now, originally I'm from Nebraska, so to me, I don't think we have cold winters. But for here, two of the main water pipes in our major high school burst because they run on the outside of the building.